Hello everyone, I'm Zach and welcome back to another HitFilm tutorial. Today I'll be showing you how to create this metallic title inspired by the Mortal Kombat trailer. I'll be using the Surface Studio and custom light flares effects, which are HitFilm Pro exclusives. A similar result can be achieved for free in Express by using the parallax effect and regular light flares effect. You can find the project file for the Pro and Express versions of this title in the video description. An essential aspect of an epic title sequence is using the right font. The font I'm using is free from defont.com, link in the description. Once you have downloaded and installed the font, open up a new composite shot in HitFilm. Add a new text layer and type out your text. Select the font, then increase the font size and letter spacing. I'll add a few spaces in between the words to make room for the logo. Create a new square composite shot. Add a new white plane, then double-click the ellipse mask tool to create a circle that fills the frame. Duplicate the mask, set its blend to subtract, and decrease the expansion to create a ring shape. Drag in your logo image and adjust the scale to fit inside the circle. I'll add a fill color effect to make it a solid gray color. Drag this comp into the previous comp and scale it down. Add a new composite shot and drag in the finished logo. This is where the final title will come together. Animate the scale of the logo so it slowly zooms in over the whole shot. To bevel the text, I'll be using the Surface Studio effect exclusive to HitFilm Pro. If you are using Express, stay tuned for a free method to achieve a similar result. Add the Surface Studio effect to the logo. In the Surface 1 controls, remove the edge offset and increase the bevel height to 100%. Then increase the bevel size until you are happy with how it looks. Let's add our own lighting instead of the built-in default lights. Set the illumination type to comp lights, then add a new light layer. Set the type to directional, then position the light so it is above the logo pointing down at it. I also chose to add an additional light, this time a red colored point light. I placed it in front of the center logo and reduced its intensity and reach to make it more subtle. We can improve this title even further by adjusting the material properties. I'll increase the specular all the way, causing the bright highlights to stand out more. To make the logo feel a little more metallic, I'll drag in an image to use for reflections. I'll make this image into its own comp and add a heavy blur effect, as I don't need this much detail. Back in our main comp, drag it onto the timeline, hide it, and select it as the environment layer. To see the reflections, reduce the Fresnel value. This is looking good, and we can tweak it even further later on with our final color grade. If you are using HitFilm Express, you can still create beveled text like this for free. The key to this result is the parallax effect, which gives the appearance of 3D depth by using a height map. In the media panel, make the logo layout comp into another composite shot. Apply the matte cleaner effect. Check view matte. Then increase the feather setting until you see a sharp edge in the middle of your logo. Bring this height map back into the final title comp and hide it. Parent it to the scaling logo layer and reset its transform so it follows the movement. Add the parallax effect to the logo, selecting your height map. This doesn't seem to have done anything. To see the effect, add a new light layer. Cool! Our text now appears to have a 3D bevel. Check this box to invert the height map so the bevel goes in the right direction. I chose to reduce the depth a little and to add some blur to smoothen the result. I don't want the text to be completely dark, so we'll add another light, this time an ambient light. Reduce the intensity so it isn't too strong. You can also play with the material settings on the parallax effect to control how the lighting affects the logo. The completed Express project file is available for download, so you can see the other settings I used, or even use it as a template. A great way to make this metallic title look more interesting is to add some small light flares glinting on the bright spots of the logo. Add a new black plane layer, setting the blend mode to add. Apply the custom light flares effect and select the tiny glint preset. If you are in HitFilm Express, use the standard light flares effect, choose a flare type, and reduce the global saturation. Also adjust the other flare settings. Place the flare on a bright spot of your logo, then adjust the intensity and scale as needed. Duplicate the effect and move the flare to another location. Position the flares on the first frame of the shot when the logo is the smallest. Then parent the flare layer to the logo layer, so it scales up with it. If we position the flares on a later frame, and then parented the layer, we would see the edges of the plane as the flare glows cut off. To finish off the title, I added a new grade layer and added a curves effect to adjust the color. I added more contrast and lifted the blue and the shadows a little. I also applied glow, chromatic aberration, a slight radial blur, and film grain. These effects add some imperfections and interest to the title, making it feel a little more realistic, matching the style of the other shots in the sequence. To slowly fade in the title, I added a new grade layer with an exposure effect. I animated the gamma to decrease towards the beginning of the shot, so the brighter areas fade in before the dark areas. In Express, I used the gamma effect and animated all three values. I then animated a black fill color effect to fade it out completely. And that's how you can create your own Mortal Kombat title effect in HitFilm. Feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions or if you learned something new. Don't forget to check out our other Mortal Kombat tutorials, including retro video game effects and Sub-Zero Ice VFX. Subscribe for more tutorials like this and be sure to give this video a like. See you next time!